This case of quadriplegia allows us to have closer look at the structural deformities typical for spastic cerebral palsy. The shoulder blades of this boy are shifted sideways and upwards, giving appearance of the wings. A boy sits on his sacrum and has to hold himself with his arms in order not to fall backwards. His rib cage is obviously deformed. All these deformities are structural and therefore generally regarded as unchangeable. Deformity of his rib cage is very visible when he lies down. The lower ribs protrude sideways and forwards, the upper chest is deflated, shoulders are protracted forwards, his lower jaw is retracted and very narrow. A closer look at his neck shows extreme weakness. His neck bulges sideways, his trachea bulges forwards. There is practically no division between his neck and his jawline. His clavicles have folded inwards, losing their normal horizontally oriented position. His shoulders moved upwards and inwards. This view shows us shortness and tightness of lateral muscles of his neck. As a result, he moves as a single unit. Legs are being moved simultaneously with his upper body. At the time of filming, the boy is 7 years old. His parents spent all these years trying various rehabilitation programs, teaching him as much function as his structural limitations would allow. A boy is extremely cooperative and he is trying to show what he learned. He shows how he learned to use his leg. However, as we can see, persistent structural deformities give little room for proper function. Next test shows that this boy cannot even control his kneeling. He shakes involuntarily with all his body and has no balance. And we ask a question. What is the point of training or walking when there is no foundation for it? We believe that the structure should be corrected first, from the top downwards, respecting the normal sequence of motor development.
Proceeding to the feet. When we will restore sufficient capacity for him to develop independent kneeling. And you can clearly see that it's changing, right? So you see,
ABR rebuilt the structure from the upper girdle, following the sequence of normal motor development. 2 years later, the contrast of structural appearance of this boy is quite dramatic. His chest expanded, his lower ribs no longer protrude outwards. His clavicles are coming closer and closer to their normal horizontal position. Shoulders are no longer protracted forwards. His neck consolidated and no longer bulges. Side view shows clear transition of his shoulder blades that move from his side much more backwards. As a result, he no longer needs to support himself by his arms in sitting. His neck elongated, his shoulders broadened. Without the need to support his body, the boy now shows an excellent range of movement in his arm. His shoulder blades no longer look like protruding wings. He can now control each of his arms independently, creating the opportunities for performing complex tasks.
Push my hand. Yeah, good, push my hand. Push my hand. Good job.
Please note the changes of the face, especially of the lower jaw. His lower jaw got wider and there is a clear division between his jaw and his neck. His shoulders no longer collapse inwards when he moves his head. The movements of his head are now independent from his arms. All these achievements are building blocks of what is going to end up as a normal structure. A view from behind clearly shows the change of the sitting platform. It is the bottom of his pelvis now and no longer his sacrum as before. As a result, he developed the mobility of his upper body, which is quite well separated from mobility of his leg. Before ABR, his legs rigidly followed any movement of his upper body. Over his 2 years with ABR, we built a solid upper body, releasing the movements of his head, neck, arms and trunk. Only now it is possible to start addressing his lower part. This boy now has a solid control of his sitting and his arms. His next stage is free, unsupported high kneeling, and only after that his structure would allow him to get vertical. This is a difficult case, but his parents are extremely dedicated and will surely get there in not so distant future.